Good morning, students. How are you all? Hope you are doing good at home. So we have done exercise 3.1 of the chapter 3, that is decimal. Now we are shifting to this next exercise, that is 3.2. And what we have to do in the exercise is, if a decimal number is divided by 10, 100 or 1000, what answer will you get? In the last exercise, what we have studied, that if any number is multiplied by 10, this decimal will shift to the right by one digit. So 2.5. In the same way, if the number is multiplied by 100, the decimal will shift to the right by two digits. So 25. In the same way, if this number is multiplied by 1000, the number will shift to three positions to the right. But here there are only two positions, so we will add one position, that is 0. So you will get 250. Okay, so this we have studied in the last exercise. Okay, now if we are dividing it with 10, 100 or 1000, what answer we will get? So let's see that if 15.5 is divided by 10, this decimal will shift to the left by one digit. So we will get 1.55. Okay, here 14.17 is divided by 10. So this decimal will move to the left by one digit. So what answer we will get? 1.417. If this 6.42 is divided by 10, this decimal will move to the left by one digit. So you will get 0.642. In the same way, 323.8 is divided by 100. So this decimal will move to the left by two digit. So 3.238. Okay. 84.84 is divided by 100. So here this decimal will move to the left by two digit. So it will be 0.8484. Okay. Now 9999.9 is divided by 1000. So this decimal will move three position to the left. So what you will get? 9.9999. Okay. Understood? In case of multiplication, the decimal will shift to the right by number of digits we are multiplying it with, and if we are dividing it, the decimal will shift to the left. Okay, hopefully you have understood the concept. Let's move on to the next question. Now here we have to fill in the blanks. 356.4 should be divided by which number in order to get 35.64? Here you can see that this decimal is shifted to the left by one number. If this decimal is shifted to the left by one number, so we will divide it by 10, then only we will get this answer. Okay. Now 6.51 should be divided by which number in order to get 0.651? Here it is before 2, means it is before 2 numbers, the decimal is before 2 numbers, and here it is before 3 numbers. So the decimal has shifted to one position to the left, so we will also divide it by 10 in order to get result 0.651. Now here 7.29 should be divided at which number to get 0.0729? So here you will see that here decimal has shifted two position to the left. Okay, 0.07. So 7 and then 0. So two position means we have to divide it by 100. Now here you can see that it is given 25.8 should be divided with which number in order to get 0.0258. So here we will see that here it is 25.8 and the decimal has shifted to three position. Okay, the decimal has shifted to three position. Okay, then only we can get 0.058. so three position means 1000. We should divide it by 1000 in order to get 0.0258. hopefully you have understood the exercise. Let's move on to the third question. Now here we have to express these things with help of decimals. So 340 paisa in rupees. Okay, we know that 1 rupee is equal to 100 paise. Okay, 100 paise, So 340 paisa will be how much? So we will divide it 340 by 100, and what you will get? We will place this decimal to the left position by two numbers. So we will get 3.40. Okay. In the same way, 9312 meter in kilometers. So 1000 meters is equal to 1 kilometer. So 9312 meter is equal to how much? So we will divide this 9312 with 1000. So what you will get? 9.312 kilometers. Okay? Understood? In this way, you can do the conversion with the help of decimals. Okay? Thank you. Hopefully you have understood and will able to do the exercise by yourself. If you have any problem, we will meet in the next lecture. Till then, take care. Goodbye. Thank you.